there's such a great experience at Broad Run Vineyards, we had to go someplace to further the experience. So we came here to the Napa River Grill, which is here in Louisville, to enjoy
a great wine restaurant
and food. In fact, what did you have for lunch?
Well, we started off with the two of their signature appetizers, the shrimp. It's served escargot style, really, and cheese and roasted garlic, shrimp scampi, and the calamari, which was great. And then I've come here a lot. I've never had the hot ground here, and I'm always looking for who in Louisville has the best hot ground. And I can tell you, theirs was top drawer.
And I had a tuna salad, which was great. Mark, who's behind the camera, had a big lasagna, and he had a big wedge salad.
Yeah, he did.
So, not only is Napa River a great place to come to for...
There's two other places that I think of. I think of wine. I think of Jenica's, which is a wine bar.
East Market,
close in downtown. And then right on the edge of downtown in the Clifton neighborhood is the Ln Wine Bar, also a fascinating place as well.
Well, we've learned so much by going out to the Broad Run Vineyard.
Weren't they cute?
I'm a big, avid wine person, and we just sat there and kept shooting because we learned so much, and they're so passionate.
It's a different place. It's not like when you go to Napa and there's small boutique wineries that I love. Then they've got the mega complexes that are, real Disneyland, and it's not that. There's no tram ride or gondola.
Well, they spend their money on that, the wine.
Right. It's very homespun. It's very rustic and just very real. They were just a joy. I could have sat there all day and listened to their tales. They're just such a cute couple.
And right now we've got also a little map here.
Yeah, this is a product of the state tourism. This is the Kentucky Wine Trail.
In fact, you go to KentuckyWine.com.
Yes, it's a nice little Z card, and they give you a map and talk about the 34 wineries that are on this trail. There are about 50 in Kentucky now. It's a real interesting story. I think we referred to it earlier that Kentucky actually had the first commercial vineyard. Prohibition wiped that industry out, and just within the last, I'd say 10 to 15 years, the Kentucky wines are really becoming noted again. And so there's a nice trail that they've put around.
Well, we're glad that we were able to take you along with us on this journey. Now, if you have any questions about this podcast or you would like to participate, just send us an email, podcast@golouisville.com. And of course, if we use your email, we'll send you some swag.
Maybe a bottle of Broad Run.
You never know. Well, as always,
you're looking at Louisville.
See you real soon.